Thanks, Becky. I'm Yanjun, and the work I'm going to present today is the work done by me and my advisor, Becky Pessene, and a brilliant undergrad, Andrew Warner, who's having thank you video right now. And we also appreciate TLT for their great support. Before we get into the demo, I think there's three questions we want to address. So what do the summaries look like? What are the challenges in the summary content analysis? And what is our method? To answer the first question, I want to show you an instruction we showed to the community college student. We asked them to read a passage about what is matter and answer the following questions. And based on those questions they answered, they need to compose a summary. Then we asked a few master students, actually it's five. We asked five master students to do the same thing, to read the same passage and answer the same questions, then compose the same summaries. And intuitively, the summaries coming from master students, we have higher quality than the community college student. So we think the summary coming from master student could be used as our model summary. Then, what are the challenges in this method? Well, let's think about each summary is a set of idea units. So we can see from this diagram, idea 1 has been mentioned 3 times across 3 summaries, while the idea 4, idea 3, and idea 2 has been only mentioned twice. So we could think of like the summaries that has the higher quality will have some content overlap, while there's also some differences. So based on this Venn diagram, we could come up with a pyramid content model. So look at this model. Each square represents a distinct idea unit, and each black dot in the square represents a piece of information you could get out from the model summaries. So we could have 5 text boxes here representing their 5 pieces of information sharing the same ideas. That's why we put them into the same square. And you can see the weight of the square is 5 because there are 5 summaries mentioned the same idea. And they're also like weighted 4, weighted 3, weighted 2, and weighted 1. So based on the pyramid content model, we could come up with the scoring method. Here is the target summary, the actual target summary we're going to score in the demo. So you can see chemical property describe matter when it is changed with a different kind of property. Has been matched with a content unit weighted 5 here. And the other one, energy, can be transferred to one object to another. This piece of information has been matched with a content unit weighted 3. So from this graph, we can see the pyramid method not only tells you how many important ideas this target summary has mentioned, but also tell you how heavy are those ideas. We have 2 various methods. One is peer score, the other one is peak. So peer score take the input as manual pyramids and use the manual pyramid to score the target summaries. And it uses a brute force method, which is the n-gram, to find all possible word strings as the segmentation. Then it uses a statistical phrase vector to do the semantic similarity evaluation. And peak, which is the later version of peer score, build up the automated pyramid and use it to score the summaries. Then it has an automated subject predicate object detection from the OpenIE. And it also uses a random works on WordNet to do the semantic similarity. So you can see I highlighted here, peer score is accurate but is incomplete because it won't build automated pyramid. And peak is accurate but is super slow. Now we power to present peer eval, a faster, complete and multiple use components, and accurate tour. So what you're looking at right now is a Stanford Core NLP tour. That is the pre-process before we use the peer eval. So Stanford Core NLP tour is a natural language processing toolkit you could use to pull out the syntactic information or sentence structure. So our method is based on the output from Stanford Core NLP. The first step we're going to do is to use the preprocess.py, which is the script in the PureUL to do preprocessing on the output from Stanford Code NLP. And the argument 2 here means I'm going to do preprocessing on the model summaries. If the argument indicates 1, that means you're doing the preprocessing on the target summaries. So there are 2 steps in the preprocess. The first one is sentence decomposition parser, which is decomposing sentence from the summary. So this is a new technology we're using on PureUL. Other than using m-grams or just the OpenIE information, we build up a new parser called sentence decomposition parser based on the syntactic structure from the raw test. And we pull out each idea unit that's thematically individual. So in other words, other than we just using a brute force method, we can pull out a piece of information that's really meaningful and that's readable. And the other steps for the processing is the vectorizing the ideas from the decomposition parser. So that is used for the semantic similarity evaluation later on. The next step, which is the most exciting part, we're gonna use the output from preprocessing to build up the pyramid. So I'm going back. Now I'm proud to present our brand new core for PureUL. EDUA, Emergent Discovery of Units of Attraction. It's a totally new algorithm we're using for the allocation of the ideal units and make them into the same square, which is the pyramid counter model we were looking at before. So why I said it's the most exciting part? Because, well, we know that there's so many ways to express an idea. There's so many possible combinations you could get out from one sentence. And you need to make sure those combinations are meaningful. And you also need to make sure those combinations could go into the most appropriate, most accurate content unit in order to build up the pyramid content model. So by speaking of that, we can see it's a computationally hard and expensive problem. But right now, what EDUA is tackling here, it's using 38 seconds to build such a pyramid, comparing to what PIG does. PIG is the previous version we built up the pyramid. So PIG used 2 or more than 2 hours to finish that job. Right now it's only taking us for 38 seconds. Then we're gonna use this pyramid to score the target summary, which is the target summaries we were looking at from the slides. So the scoring.py is the script we're using to score the target summaries. We have a few arguments here. Dash pin means you're selecting the pyramid build up from the last step, and we're using the pyramid we just built. And dash A means I want to output the verbals. And dash T means I want to output the score table. Let's go. Well, it's doing the same thing as the building up the pyramid. It's using the same preprocessing and also the same vectorizing for it. Okay, so let's look at the wonderful result. So we have this target summary here, and you see now you will see the qualitative analysis and also quantitative analysis. So it's a huge improvement than the 2 previous methods. So let's look at the quantitative result first. The raw score is 48. That means the content unit list shown here is the sum of the raw score is the sum of all the matched content units in the pyramid matched with the target summaries. So the raw score is 48. Then the quality score is the raw score scaled by the maximum scores you could get now from matching the pyramid. And we see the quality score is 53. It's not very good. Then coverage means how many important ideas in the pyramid have been covered in the target summary. So it's very intuitive. Then comprehensive score is the average between quality and coverage. It will give you a general idea of how well the student is doing on the summarization. And let's look at the qualitative part. Okay, let's look at the example here. Sentence 3, segmentation 1. So segmentation means the combination we pull out from the sentence decomposition parser, if you recall, which is the new parser we built for getting the piece of information from the raw sentence. Then we have the content unit, which is the content unit in the pyramid, has been matched with this piece of information. So if you look at that, there are three pieces of information in this content unit, and they're sharing the same ideas as the target summary. So that's why for this piece of information, it got scored as three. Then the other one is, we can look at the content unit only has one contributor, which is only has one piece of information. So it got matched with this segment, matches what certain amount of material the object has. Yeah, I think I'm basically done. Any question? Thank you.